So I got the recorder going. We're down on the waterfront, and this is John Hill, the world traveler, the commuter from good old Florida, comes up here to entertain us. So we're in for a treat. What are you going to play for us? What are you going to play for us?
Oh, what do we want? Blues or?
Oh, blues. I love blues.
Yeah. Okay.
What are you going to play for us? There?
Okay.
Can you do me a favor before we do the video? Can you take that hat off because it causes a shadow and the camera can't see your face at all. It's too dark. Let me see. Is that going to work? Yeah, that'll work. No, that'll work. No, that's good.
Okay.
Well, it's very dark outside right now, but at least now I can see your face. Okay. So it's still recording, and why I'm doing this recording mostly is for you to introduce you to Gideon Rogers.
Sure.
He's already got playlists, and when he comes over, I'll show him your video.
Yeah.
So say hi to Gideon.
Hi, Gideon.
Yeah. And there's another guy named Pierre Porter. He's a bass guitar. And I've got other people already lined up now, so we've got a pretty good thing happening. We didn't have a sax player.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Now
we want to... Oh, yeah. Do you know any
sax player?
Do you know anything that's like Jamaican or you know that part of the world, just below Florida?
I don't think so.
Or anything that's from the old, you know, old stuff from that you know, if they would have played in Florida? Because Gideon's an older guy that plays that kind of stuff, like really beautiful stuff with real feeling and emotion in it. You know, the really classy stuff that they used to have years ago. Gideon puts together really beautiful stuff. So,
I don't know. I was just thinking of the. I don't know.
Anything of New Orleans? Anything French?
French?
Yeah.
Anything New Orleans?
Yeah, even New Orleans. That's a French
you know
system.
What it means to miss New Orleans.
Okay, what's it mean?
An old song.
You gonna want to play it? Yeah, so you were saying that some people like Roland Callender, my old friend that I haven't seen him since last year he didn't show up here, but he always came back from BC and bussed here all summer. Last year is the first year he didn't come. He's like 81 years old.
Yeah.
So I've done a lot of videos of him, and he plays the sax. And he's been playing the sax for his whole life. And the sax that he's got is he inherited from his family, so it's even older than him.
Yeah.
And he played all kinds of amazing stuff. He had his own band at one time. He was touring around, but he can't read a note. Can I read a note? He plays everything from memory, and he never makes a mistake. You know, he's got quite a repertoire.
Well, you develop that. You develop that to the point where you don't even want to read a note.
Yeah.
You don't want to be tied to that.
How well do you, if you listen to... a classy kind of fashion type of song, because I don't know all the names of all the genres, there's so many.
Yeah.
But how fast do you catch, let's say you got a band playing and they want you to, how fast do you catch on with them? Like, you don't always have to know how to read their music to be able to play it.
Oh, no.
That's what I mean, yeah.
You mean doing a...
Well, whatever he wants you, because I know how you come along slowly as you learn it, but they can, you know, you know music how to explain it better than I do, but... A guy like you, if you get to a band that's being put together, everybody starts knowing each other and they start trying things out, and it flows. That's how it works.
You,
you, if it does, if there's not a bond and a flow between the people, it's never going to work. But Gideon is...
It depends on how much is written. I mean, if I can... I go to a studio and play a chord and lay down tracks for them.
Okay, that's what they're working on. He wants to put a new album together, okay? Because he's got like, I did one last year with him. I didn't put it on CD. I just have it on video. And he's got five other albums that he hasn't marketed yet. And I've set up all the websites for him already. Everything's all done. And so we're just continuing with the projects. And I do a lot of photo shoots and videos in the summertime. So I'm trying to finish it up with him. So that, you know, but that Cannabis Day concert, that's going to be a good place to go because it's all free and there's going to be a sound system there. There's going to be band members there from all different groups. And there'll be jamming, they might not be jamming, but it's going to be a great place to meet a lot of musical people.
Yeah. Well, I know all of the old ones here.
There's going to be old ones, but remember that the young ones have to meet the old ones so that the stuff continues.
You know, like... I lost two friends last year. Their funerals were on the same day.
Yeah.
Which was kind of a stretch. I had to be from one to the other. Bucky Adams and Frank Ridgway. Frank was really good trumpet.
So Gideon is not from Canada. He spends a good part of his time here now. But he's not a Canadian. I don't think he doesn't know the history of all the names of people that are performers in this part of the world. He's not from here. St. Kitts is quite a ways from here. Yeah. It's a small little tiny country, but it's on an island with another country beside it.
Caribbean St. Nevis, N-E-V-I-S.
That's it, yeah, that's the name of it.
The other island.
Yeah. So that's where he's from, so.
Yeah.
He's got some really nice music that's beautiful to listen to. You can have a party, like, really young people are not going to necessarily like it, but he writes his own stuff, and what he writes is current. Like, he's got some pretty good ideas and pretty good songs that will reach anybody. So he kind of broke any barriers that might have been, because if you listen to his albums and listen to the topics, he's got political songs. He's got all different kinds, and he's...
Well, yeah. The trouble with music, the thing here is that this kind of music... I'm trying to catch the attention.
You mean right here on the waterfront?
By here.
Yeah, well, I know. It's like they only hear you for a few seconds and they're gone.
Yeah. So there's maybe about four or five tunes that anybody will catch.
Yeah.
Well, you know, that's okay. That's 10 minutes worth of music. And then what do you do?
Another 10 minutes and same one over. But if you play the same one all day long, you can get pretty bored with it too.
Well, somebody's actually here for a little while.
They might see you today and see you tomorrow, like the next day, like, this guy always play the same stuff?
I mean, you know, like there's one, a relatively new one by, what's his name, Van Halen or something?
Van Halen.
Anyway, I do that fair amount, but it's hard because most of the music written these days or played these days, popular stuff, is really not, doesn't have a melody.
Yeah.
See, and therefore it's quite unrecognizable unless you're a drummer or a guitarist.
Yeah. So we're gonna end this video because now Gideon will have an idea who you are. Right now, last I spoke to him, he was testing out a drummer, but it's kind of hard to test drummers because you've got to have the right location to make noise, right? So that's one of the reasons why it's hard to get drummers. People, there's a lot of bands that want drummers, but they can't get them because drummers don't have any place to play. You can't play anywhere. You got to go like, 50 miles away from any nearest house before you can bang away and make a bunch of noise or have a bomb shelter, you know, in your basement. So that's why in this town there's a lot of people that want drummers. So Gideon was trying one out.
Yeah. There are a fair amount of good drummers. The horn guys are usually a little older now. It's too bad. Guys playing in here, Jeff Goodsby, he and John Hollis, and a few of those others, they were all kind of students of mine back when I was doing a jazz thing at Dalhousie.
There's a young guy I saw in the water on Spring Garden Road a couple days ago. I didn't do any recordings of him. I didn't have any time. But he's like 21, 22 by the looks of him. And he plays one about that size. He plays really, really well. So they had a huge crowd. So there's only in this town, there's only a couple of people that I've heard that have picked up a saxophone and are good at it. Only two. That are young, right? The new gen. There's only two that I ever heard. So he's one of them, and I was another one I heard before. It's not very many people that play a sax, and it's a beautiful instrument.
It used to be the thing back in the 50s.
Or even further back than that.
40s, 50s, 60s. Yeah. That's where I was.
I'm going to zoom in. Don't move your... No, leave it right there. So I'm going to zoom in to the instrument, and then I'm going to turn off the video. So just hold it still for a second.
Okay, this instrument...
Don't turn it, because I want to get the words. Okay, there we go.
My daddy bought it new the year I was born.
You keep talking about the instrument while I... Don't move it so the camera stays zoomed. Just let me stay focused. Here we go.
Bundy. Back when the Bundys were the top of the line of the sound room. This is back in 1938 is its year. And I like it. But it's also, you know, Dad's gone now, of course. And I used to sit in with his dance band back in the 50s and 40s. Back when I was about 14 years old.
So you said your dad used to play it?
Oh yeah, cool. Well, Dad had it. He played everything, trombone, violin, everything.
So right now I'm looking at the timer on my clock. I'm going to turn off the radio now. Thank you. Okay.